welcome you back. Our next topic is power. So power. So to do with power, you need to think, always think about the work which has been done and the time taken to do that particular work. So when you have those two, you'll always come up with power. Power is the, it's just the rate of transfer of energy. Or you can easily say work done per unit time. The amount of work done in a particular time is what we call power. But you have seen already that work done is force times distance moved in direction of the force. Then the time taken is T. So power becomes force times distance divided by time. If we simplify, you can say force times distance over time. But distance over time is speed or velocity for this case. So we can easily say that since S over T is velocity, then power becomes FV, where F is force and V is the velocity that body moves with, or the speed that body moves with in a specified direction. Then the S unit of power is watts, or sometimes we can say joules per second. Now joules per second defines work done, because work done is in joules, and time taken is in seconds. So you can take joules per second or watts. There are other units of power like kilowatts, megawatts, gigawatts, microwatts, among others. Then power can also be measured in horsepower, especially in the American version. They measure power in horsepower. So one horsepower is equivalent to 746 watts, or you can say 0.746 kilowatts that way. Now your simple research is to find the definition of a watt. The definition of a watt. A watt is that SI unit of power. So you should give a clear definition. Don't just say it's the SI unit of power. That will be wrong. I need the definition of watt and the definition of a joule. In our discussion, I would expect you to be able to explain what a watt is and what a joule is. Thank you. What comes next here is an example. So this example is very easy. If you can look at it, maybe I can explain this to you in the next session.